6:35 in Trinidad and Tobago. Let's continue with our lead-in to our big event. But before that, as far as the TV6 Viewers' Choice Sports Personality of the Year, that is coming up. We're going to have the big lead-in in a short while. But as promised, let's link up with the president of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, David John Williams. We've managed to make contact with him this morning. Good morning to you, David. Thanks very much for joining us.
Good morning, Fazeer. Good morning to your viewers and listeners. Always a pleasure, and let me wish you all the best for this season, and 2019 will be prosperous for you and the family and your viewers.
And thank you very much for those kind greetings, and we extend the same to you. And in that context, David, in your capacity as president of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, before we get your perspective on this issue about players and potential strike and outstanding monies and so on, as far as the TTFA's next election and general meeting process, where exactly is that at right now?
There was a vote of no confidence against the president, which was defeated. So that process is out of the way. What is left to do in the general meeting is the approval of the budget for 2019. So that's where we are at the moment.
You were just breaking up a little bit, David. If you could just, we heard the part where the no confidence motion being defeated. But just to clarify once again, what happens next as far as the next election of officers?
Well, that is due in 2019. Fazeer, is constitutionally due in 2019, and the process will go ahead as normal.
Okay, thanks very much for that clarification. Now, let's get to the issue of this claim by players of outstanding monies and their threat to boycott upcoming friendly internationals, including the game against Wales. What is your reaction to that information?
First of all, Fazeer, let me put on record that the TTFA has started to pay the players. We have about 3 games outstanding for them now. Over the past week, we have paid them for 3 games. There's no secret that the TTFA has serious cash flow problems. And that was due to the fact that we have been paying on a lot of debt that has been inherited from previous administration. I mean, today we have paid them over $8.5 million of debt. And it has seriously infected our cash flow. The TTFA has deliberately not approached government to deal with this situation, because we know the country doesn't have any money, and we have to get away from that mindset of always depending on government to bail us out. As president, I'm trying to push the organization into a self-sustainable mode. So directly to your question, we feel confident that before the next international game, which against Wales, the players will be settled.
And based on the reporting of the players' issues, you are being accused directly of going back on your word as far as promised payments by certain times. What say you to that accusation?
And Fazeer, we were expecting some inflows by the 15th of December. Unfortunately, that did not happen. We expect the inflows within the next 10 to 15 days, and we will deal with the matter. Basically, we have to depend on where our funding is going to come from, and we are depending on external sources, and unfortunately, it didn't come on time.
And given that situation, and given the internal issues within the administration of the TTFA, the motion of no confidence, just the general level of performance of our different national teams, what is your own perspective as a final thought coming towards the end of 2018, moving into 2019? Is there any ground? Are there any grounds for optimism?
Well, Fazeer, let me put on record again. I've always said it. Trinidad football has not really been built on solid rock. It has been built on sand. We have to start football all over. We live in a society that is success-oriented and success-driven. And many people depend on, many people see the success of an administration based on the results on the field. I mean, at the end of the day, yes, it's important. Yes, it's important to qualify for world tournaments and regional championships. But this administration has found itself in dealing with trying to survive out fires every day, and trying to push the organization towards self-sustainability. We have worked very hard to start the football from scratch, and that's it.
And just in relation to that, and we're just going over a little bit by about 60 seconds, just to get your view on that. I take your point about the need to have a solid foundation. But do you accept, as you are, you and the administration are being accused of almost mashing up the national setup because of the struggles that various national teams have had, that trickles downwards as far as causing a lack of confidence in the football product of Trinidad and Tobago?
Fazeer, it's your interview, but when you have inherited $30 million in debt and you as an administration have to pay down that debt, I mean, just think about if we had $8.5 million in our cash flow at the moment, I wouldn't be having this interview with you.
And you are satisfied that from your own perspective, it has been managed as best as it could, given the prevailing circumstances?
Fazeer, put it this way. When we came into office, the first debt we had to pay was $220,000 to Ivan Peller Road, a debt from 2010. That is $210,000. If we had that single money, I won't be having an interview with you.
David John Williams, thanks very much for taking the time to give us a brief perspective on what is obviously a very challenging situation for football in Trinidad and Tobago. We'll take a break and then we'll head in to our lead-in. We'll let off the starting pistol for our countdown to the TV6 Sports Personality for 2018. The Viewer's Choice. We'll be back right after this break.